Thanks, Traveler, for joining me on my caravan trip from Perth to Darwin and return. This section is from Newman to Meekatharra on National Highway 95. The distance from Newman to Meekatharra is about 400 kilometers. Coombe Arena is a road station with a caravan park behind. We fill up with petrol and talk to the girl that had been there for almost a year. Quite unusual for these isolated places. The image of the place is perhaps captured by this artwork on the interior wall. We were all impressed by this girl's colorful outfit. Well, we've got petrol, we're moving on to the Gascoyne River, where there's a 24-hour stopover. We can camp free of charge at the halfway point. We've arrived at the bridge over the mighty Gascoyne River, which empties in Carnarvon. We pull off the main highway on quite a substantial road over a cattle grid to the river itself. This is really a substantial area for camping and caravanning. Could probably accommodate 30 or 40 caravans. We set up camp next to the river. The old road used to cross the Gascoyne River just below the actual bridge today. In those days, you didn't travel in the wet season. They just had a concrete pad for the river to run over, and one waited for the flood to subside. Well, it's the middle of November, the end of the dry season. The river is virtually dry. There are only a few small pools. My friend Jamie goes fishing for small mullet in the pools. Too far south for crocodiles. Well, we spent the night and it's the next day. This landscape is dead flat and incredibly boring. We push on south towards the Murchison River. I decide to take a tour on the Aspertan Meekatharra Road. The road runs west towards Peak Hill and eventually to Mount Augustus, but 20 kilometers up the road is apparently the remains of an old gold town and a number of old gold mines. We decide to explore. The road is quite bumpy and we need to go quite slowly, about 30 kilometers an hour. And in spots, signs say road subject to flooding. We reach the Murchison and where the remains of the old gold mining area was, but there's not too much to see except lots of cattle. This is a popular 24-hour stopover, but it's not an official one. There's no rubbish collection or toilets. People just camp alongside the river. There's a large herd of cattle with some bulls. We decide we're not going to get out and do much exploring after all, particularly with calves around. We wonder what those cattle eat. The land has been stripped of all grass. There's a variety of bird life on what remains of the Murchison River at the end of the dry season. My traveling companion, Jamie. Well, we didn't see any remains of gold mines or even any old wrecks of cars. It was a bit of a disappointment. We push back to the National Highway and continue on towards Meekatharra. We're almost there, 5 kilometers to go. Signs of civilization with the 50 kilometer speed limit. The outskirts of Meekatharra. We drive right through town to the Mikathera Caravan Park, pay our money, and park behind this service station. I go exploring. Mikathera has some excellent cycle trails with interpretive literature. Adventures in Mikathera in my next little film. Thank you, adventurer, for joining me on this trip between Newman and Mikathera. Hope you have a really great day.